What's going on, everybody? This is Elder Cody Owens coming to you Tuesday, October 14th, for Testimony Tuesday. Now, a friend of mine had asked me, you know, what exactly is a testimony and how do you give it? So I just want to spend a couple minutes and just talk about that very briefly. You know, when you look at a testimony, your testimony is something that God has done for you that brings glory to His name. You know, it's something that He's done for you that you give, that you're aware and you acknowledge that He did this. You know, you're giving Him the glory where the glory is due. It's just like giving credit where credit is due. You know, for instance, I'm going to read this from Genesis 45. And I'll read just verse 5. Now, therefore, be not grieved nor angry with yourselves that ye sold me hither. For God did send me before you to preserve life. Now, in this portion of scripture, Joseph is talking to his brothers, which he had been playing with for a little bit, sending them back and forth, setting them up. You know, he's been playing with them for a little bit. But he told them, look, don't be mad at yourselves. Don't be angry, because all that you thought that you did to me, I understand and I see how God planned it out for our preservation. God gave Joseph a dream, and Joseph shared his dream with his brothers and his father, and they're like, man, get out of here. I'm paraphrasing, of course. Get out of here. Even his father, Jacob, was like, boy, you're crazy. Get out of here. And we're all going to bow down to you. You know, so, but his brothers had begun to despise Joseph, and they sold him into Egypt, and he was sold as a slave. But God favored Joseph, and Joseph became he became elevated in his master's house. You know, everything that was of his master's, Joseph had charge over except for his wife. And, you know, so things went sour in that situation because the wife wanted Joseph. And then Joseph was put in prison. And then Joseph, again, by the grace of God, by the hand of God, was elevated to a top position in the prison. And everything that went on in the prison, as far as the prisons were concerned, Joseph was in charge. He was over top of it all, you know. And of course, that's by the hand of God, because God gives us favor, you know, but to do His will. Sometimes we misuse that favor. Joseph could have been bitter, like, dang, I got put in prison. You know, I got accused of rape, which I didn't even, I got accused of rape, which I didn't even do. You know, Joseph could have been bitter, like, well, I should have just slept with her. I should have just did what she wanted. At least I would have still been in my master's house. I wouldn't be here in prison. But Joseph said, no, I can't do this to God. And he suffered the consequences for, or what we think, or what it appeared that he suffered consequences for. But actually, this is God's hand moving. You know, there's a scripture that says that all things work together for the good of those who love me. You know, to those who love the King, to those who love Jesus, everything works together for the good of those who love Him. And this is working in Joseph's favor, but I'm pretty sure he doesn't really feel like it or know it at the time. So then from the prison, you know, he had met these two guys that were right under Pharaoh, and he interpreted their dreams. And what God said through Joseph, interpreting the dream, came to pass. And so when that came to pass, 2 years later, Pharaoh had a dream that no one could interpret. And then Joseph was remembered. And so then Joseph was elevated into a position, because he was able to interpret Pharaoh's dream. He was elevated into a position of power in the kingdom of Pharaoh in Egypt. He was second to Pharaoh. You know, and all this because, you know, God is fulfilling His plans, you know, but Joseph was taken very low before he was elevated up to the top, you know. And that's a beautiful testimony, which I'm sure he shared with his brothers here. Well, I'm pretty sure he shared with his brothers, but it doesn't go into the exact detail like I just shared with you. But, you know, he's saying, look, now therefore be not grieved nor angry with yourselves that ye sold me thither, for God did send me before you to preserve life. Somebody out of the 10, out of the 11 brothers saying, well, how is this? How did you even get here? And I'm pretty sure Joseph would have explained his story. I mean, you know, and that story is his testimony. And this testimony is giving glory to God because God said, and he showed me in the dream, boom, this is going to happen. I didn't understand how it was going to come to pass. But yet, look at God's hand working in my life. He allowed you guys. He allowed you to sell me into slavery. He allowed y'all to even harbor those feelings of bitterness. Now, we'd rather not. We'd rather not have had those feelings harbored against them. But yet and still, God is in control of everything. He can work everything towards his favor, whether it's anger, whether it's something that very disgusting and vile. He can work everything towards his favor. And if we are paying attention, we can see how God's hand is moved in our life. But that's his testimony. That's Joseph's testimony. And we all have testimonies, whether we want to admit it or not, whether we are believers or not. We all have testimonies. And, you know, so that's basically what, just an example of a testimony. So I guess today I just shared a testimony of Joseph. And I hope it has been a blessing to you, as it has been a blessing for me and many others. Just remember, on Mondays, we have Monday morning prayer. Tuesdays, we have Testimony Tuesday. Wednesday, I drop a quick nugget, go over a quick scripture and just talk about it very briefly. It's not a Bible study. It's just something to get you thinking, something to get your gears turning and maybe get you into your word just a little bit more. But if you have a prayer request or a testimony, feel free to leave a comment below, or you can email me at jacodyo@gmail.com. That's jacodyo@gmail.com. Till then, be blessed.